स्टूडेंट, दिस इज क्लास 12 एंड वी आर स्टडिंग फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। इन दिस फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द ओवरी, ओविडक्ट, यूट्रस एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द मेमोरी ग्लैंड। ह्यूमन फीमेल कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ पेयर ऑफ मेमोरी ग्लैंड्स कॉल्ड एज द ब्रीज। ब्रीज एंड व्हेन वी एक्सटर्नली ऑब्जर्व इट इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ निप्पल थ्रू विच चाइल्ड सक्स द मिल्क एंड अराउंड द मिल्क देर इज अ डार्क कलर्ड स्ट्रक्चर एंड दिस इज अ डार्क कलर्ड पोर्शन एंड दिस डार्क कलर पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड द एरियोला। दिस इज कॉल्ड द एरियोला एंड इन द एरियोला देर इज द निप्पल इज हियर। सो निप्पल हेल्प्स इन द सकिंग ऑफ द मिल्क बाय द चाइल्ड। If we see the internal structure of mammary gland, it is consists of mainly two parts. One is mammary gland. It is consists of two parts. One is variable amount of the fats. One is variable amount of fats and second is the glandular tissue. Second is glandular tissue. So the variable amount of the fats, these fats determine the size of the breast. If more fats are there, size of the breast may be big, and if the little amount are the small, size may be small. And this is now this glandular epithelium. This glandular epithelium is formed of mammary lobes, formed of mammary lobes. How much? 15 to 20. So glandular tissue is formed of 15 to 20 mammary lobes and it is mammary lobes are formed of clusters of alveoli. Cluster of muscles called alveoli. Called alveoli. So memory loops consist of cluster of cells, and these cluster of cells are called as the alveoli. These alveoli cells produce milk, and this milk is stored in the lumen of alveoli. Alveoli produce the milk. Which is stored in lumen of alveoli. So these alveoli opens into alveoli opens into tubules into tubules means memory tubules into memory tubules memory tubules So, alveoli opens into memory tubules. So, memory tubules join to form memory duct. Memory tubules join to form memory duct. Memory duct. So these memory ducts form memory ampulla. Memory ducts form memory, ampulla. The far memory ampulla. Ampulla is connected to lactiferous duct. Ampulla is connected to lactiferous duct through which milk is sucked out, through which milk is sucked out. So this is about the mammary gland. Once again, this is the mammary gland. It is consists of two parts. One is fats, variable amount of fats. Number one is fats. It is of variable amount. One is fat. Fats amount is the variable. Some person having the less fat and some having the more fat. So this is about the fat and other the glandular tissue. This glandular tissue is formed of 15 to 20 mammary lobes. So mammary lobes contain clusters of cells, and these clusters of cells are called as the alveoli. These alveoli secretes the milk. This milk is stored into the lumen of alveoli. The milk which is secreted by the alveoli cell is stored into the lumen of alveoli. So alveoli opens into mammary tubules. These alveoli opens into the mammary tubules. So mammary tubules, many mammary tubules join to form mammary duct. So mammary tubules join to form the mammary duct, and mammary ducts form the mammary ampulla. Mammary ducts form the mammary ampulla. This ampulla is connected to the lactiferous duct, through which milk is sucked out. So that's for mammary gland, and you can see the diagram which is given in your book. So thank you, that's for today. So hello students, we are studying female reproductive system. The female reproductive system, we have studied about the ovary, oviduct, uterus and mammary glands. Today we are going to study about the external genitalia. External genitalia. External genitalia, it includes mons, pubis, it includes moons, pubis, labia, mesura, pubis, labia, mesura, labia, minora, hymen, and clitoris. Clitoris. These structures for the external genitalia that includes mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, hymen, and the clitoris. So we have to discuss one by one. First, mons pubis. It is a thick cushion like structure fatty tissues covered by pubic hairs. Covered by pubic. If you see the structure, and that is consists of actually this region is called as the, and rest part, female reproductive part, we can found here vagina etc., but this is region is called as the mons pubic region. So it is found, we can say that the lower part of the abdomen, lowermost part of the abdomen, this is thick cushion of fatty tissues covered by the skin and pubic hairs. So next structure is labia majora. Second part, labia Labia majora. These are the two fleshy folds. Two fleshy folds. These are the two fleshy folds of fatty tissues of fatty tissues which extends down from moon's pubis and surrounds vaginal opening. Vaginal okay, now see labia majora. These are two fleshy folds of the fatty tissues which extend down from mons pubis and surrounds the vaginal opening. So if we see in the structures, so we found such type structures are there. This is clitoris and so surrounds vaginal opening. Now next structure, labia minora. Labia minora. It is found just inside the labia majora. So labia minora is found just inside the labia majora and encloses vestibules. So this is labia minora. And next on the hymen. Hymen is a membranous structure which surrounds vagina. Which surrounds the vagina and covers the opening of vagina. Hymen, this is membranous structure which covers the opening of vagina. Generally vagina breaks during first intercourse, but hymen may also break due to cycling, riding, etc., etc. So, breaking or non-breaking of hymen may not be indicator of virginity. So generally it is said that it breaks during the first intercourse, but it may be also breaks by the jumping, running, swimming, cycling, etc., etc. So hymen may not works as the indicator of virginity. Now next structure is clitoris. It is also called as the pseudopenis, and it is highly sensitive structure. So clitoris is a It is a finger-like structure. It is a finger-like structure and which lies at the upper junction of finger-like structure lies upper junction of meso. Upper junction of two minora. So this is the clitoris, highly sensitive structure. It is also called as the pseudo penis. In some countries it is removed, mainly tribal areas. So that is about the external genitalia, which includes, I told you, that is most pubis, labia majora, labia minora, hymen and the clitoris. Most pubis, it is a thick cushion of fatty tissue covered by pubic hairs. Next one, labia majora. These are the two fleshy folds of fatty tissues which extend down from mons pubis and surrounds the vaginal opening. And next one, the labia minora, found just inside the labia, labia majora, and encloses the vestibule. And next one, the hymen. This is membranous structure which covers the opening of the vagina. And this is the clitoris. This is a finger-like structure, lies upper junction up to minora. So thank you. That's for today.